I've just found a really cool way to upgrade the notch on your Mac. Today we're going to look at an app called Notchnook. It takes the notch that may be on your Mac device and turn it into something much more useful. Hello there, my name is Francesco and welcome to Tool Finder. If you're new here, subscribe. And today's video is brought to you by Sunsama. Sunsama is a powerful tool for tasks and calendar. It also has task consolidation to help you consolidate all of the tasks across all of the apps that you may use for work and life. But it also has a great focus on work-life balance, being more mindful and helping you to get more done and focusing on quality, not quantity. It's also recently got some AI features and you can find it linked below if you're interested. Thanks to Sunsama for sponsoring today's video. So let's start with the pricing. It's available at a $3 per month upgrade or one-off $25, or you can get it as part of Set App, which is basically like the Netflix for apps and productivity tools, which allows you to pay $9.99 to get access to all of them. You'll find all of those linked below. So let's take a look at how Notchnook can be helpful for your daily productivity and what it actually does. So this right here is Notchnook, and it appears at the top of your Mac. And if you hover over it, it basically pops up like a little tray that you can quickly access. Now, there are two experiences as part of this. There's an area called Nook, which is designed to bring your widgets in, which you can customize in the settings. This will allow you to add your media player, Spotify, for example, your calendar, which you're connected to as default, and your shortcuts, which you might want to use to save a bit of time. There's also a function called Mirror, and this allows you to see yourself really quickly. And the idea behind this is like a mirror, so you can basically see whether you've got any blemishes on your face or you're preparing for a video call. But I contacted the developer and they said that access to the camera is obviously controlled through the Apple device. So obviously when your green light comes on, then obviously so does the camera. So making sure that that is secure was something that was important to me, so I did check that. Obviously, the custom widgets can be moved around, but there are more widgets on the planned on the cards. Notes, quick apps, and to-do lists are part of their plans for the future. But the ability to customize these even further is really good inside the app, meaning you can change the width of certain edits. For example, if you don't want your shortcuts to be on there, but your calendar to be 10 cells wide, then that's something you can do to prioritize what it looks like. And you can even switch on and off the mirror if you didn't want that feature whatsoever. Now, inside of the Nook area, there is also an ability to enable it and not, as well as a tray area. Now, the tray area is really cool because if you want to get a document or a file that you use regularly, you can basically drag it down from the top, saving you a bunch of time. Sort of like the downloads area, but for your top of your Mac. And there are also some gestures allowing you to navigate across the different media items you're playing. So for example, if you want to quickly change songs, you can swipe left and right for that. Now there are a bunch of things in the settings, like a translucent notch bar, which will basically take away some of the side elements of this so that you can see your top of your Mac, which is really nice, and a bunch of content padding abilities as well. Now, this is just something to note, but you can also change the width of this. This also changes the sensitivity of it, I believe. But when I found one of the problems was when I was using this, I constantly found myself accidentally nudging it at the top and it opened up and I had to drop down, which actually was a bit of a pain and got sort of in the way. I also noticed as well that the tray icon appears in the top left, as well as one item in the tray, which sort of felt like another notification to keep on track. But you can also have and choose which one comes up when you open it, which is very helpful. Now, there are some bunch of live abilities that you can change as well. For example, if you want the media to show in the live activities area, this is really helpful. And you can also change a few options there. Now, the drop area does have plans to add a custom pipelines thing where you can compress images, zip them, and do a lot more beyond just the basic dragging and dropping, which is quite helpful. So this was Notchnook. It's going to be a helpful way to save you some time dragging images and quickly making the most of that notch that you've got on the top of your Mac. If you want it, you can find it linked below. But for me, I'll probably uninstall it because it's probably not much of an upgrade for me. I don't spend much time up there. But if you're somebody that really does hate the notch and want an upgrade, then this is one for you.